The Romanian yoga teacher's fate is still uncertain, as Bivolaru is caught between political asylum and imprisonment. The Swedish Supreme Court refuses the extradition request of Romania and in 2007 gives asylum to the Romanian refugee and yoga teacher Grigorian Bivolaru. Due to his beliefs, he has been persecuted since the Ceaușescu regime. In 2013, the Romanian Supreme Court convicts him in absentia to 6 years imprisonment. As a member of the European Union, Romania issues a European arrest warrant for his imprisonment, and Sweden faces a dilemma: to stand for the individual human rights as stipulated in the Geneva Convention, or to comply with the EU directives, which means the mutual respect between EU member states. The question was addressed in different occasions to the President of the Commission, José Manuel Barroso, and also to the Vice Presidents Viviane Reding and Cecilia Malmström.
I want to speak about this aspect of trust, which is very much related to the living up to the mandate. And I would say, go for having the actions that gives the fruits that actually give the trust of the individuals. And when we come to human rights, Europe now is very in a good direction, but has worked much more than on policy than actually looking with the feet on the ground what is happening. Now, last week there was a resolution here actually to look into the member states that are de facto not respecting the Copenhagen criteria or living up to the Copenhagen criteria. And this is very important. We meet again and again this problem with human rights being blatantly violated within the member states and especially some of the new member states. What is happening today is that EU is actually working against that. There is a refugee, Yogi, from Romania, who has been persecuted since the Ceaușescu times. He has asylum in Sweden. It was given 2007. Romania has 3 times asked him extradited, and Sweden defends him by the Geneva Convention. Now, as being a member of EU, Romania has posed the European arrest warrant, which ties the hands of Sweden, and the man is standing without defense because of EU policy. And this must stop, and it must. EU will have its legitimacy when they work for actually protecting the human rights against the state abuses that are still happening. Thank you very much.
Okay. We should recognize there are problems, like our Swedish friend there mentioned, the problem about the lack of respect of the rule of law in some of our member states. We are acting today. We have launched not only the CVMs for the cooperation verification mechanism, but the European Commission, when there were solid cases, we were acting against the lack of respect, including in our member states, on democracy and human rights. And we are now going to create a new system, a new instrument to fight with the non-respect of the principle of rule of law.
The question referring to Mr. Bivolaru's asylum in Sweden and the respect of human rights in his case was raised to the Vice President of the European Commission, Viviane Reding, during a citizens' dialogue in Stockholm.
It is actually the question about the system. I am the first European Justice Commissioner with power to do things. The first thing I started to do was to create procedural rights for people when they are taken by police or when they are brought in front of the court, that they have basic rights all over the place, because these rights did not exist. Why these rights did not exist? Because the European Union could not make proposals before, and think about the time. It was just after 9/11, and everything was about terrorism and criminality. And the ministers of the interior created the European arrest warrant without any procedural rights attached to it. I have attached the procedural rights to the arrest warrant and put the arrest warrant back on the table and gave out directions to the member states how they should use it. For instance, many member states try to use it for petty crime. as I always called it, the picklet way of using the arrest warrant. They asked it an extradition for somebody who had stolen something small. That is not the reason of justification. We need to have rules which go to the heart of the matter, which combine security on one hand with the rights. Both have to be in equilibrium. Both are the both sides of the same medal. The one without the other should not be allowed anymore. And that is the evolution we have had in the last years to bring the rights to questions of security.
And what do you do then to stop countries from using the system?
Because in the system already is included for what reasons a country cannot extradite. So this is very much codified and very much included. And the courts also have to decide.
In order to understand the story, we asked the lawyer of Mr. Bivolaro from European Court of Human Rights about this case. How did it start? Were the human rights respected?
In 2004, if you recall, there was a massive police raid with 300 members of the police force into the homes of yoga communities, with the consequences of massive arrestations, massive detentions, massive wide defamation and libeling campaign. With the consequences quite clear and manifest breach of his rights to presumption of innocence. And Mr. Bivolaro took then the decision to flee the country and to seek international detention abroad. He flee to Sweden, a country that granted him in 2005 political asylum for unfair trial in case he would be expelled to return to Romania, media harassment, violation of presumption of innocence, and unfair trial because of the fabricated evidence. And I am referring to the statements, the witness statements of one of the alleged victims in this case, Mrs. Dumitru Maddalena.
Hundreds of yogis complain about their treatment during the raid performed by 300 armed and masked men, primarily military personnel from the anti-terror troops. In 2006, the yogis' complaints reached the chief military public prosecutor, the Brigadier General Dan Vojna, who starts an investigation. During a series of interviews on television, General Vojna declared that the yogis and their leader Gregorian Bivolaru from Misa Yoga School in Romania were mistreated and they were persecuted by the Romanian state.
Caracterul acestor anchete este unul politic. Și atunci practic această anchetă declanșată de mine era una împotriva statului.
Mr. Vojna stated that the political character of the persecutions against yogis during the communist regime continued in the case of Misa and Gregorian Bivolaru in Romania even after the revolution of 1989. As a proof of his statements, in 2011, the Bucharest court confirms by its decision the political character of several persecutions of Mr. Bivolaru during the communist regime. Members of the European Parliament Elmar Brok, Cornelis de Jong, Jens-Peter Bonde, José Bové, Rita Borsellino, Margrethe Auken, Jean Lambert, Cornelia Ernst, Neri Deva, Nicola Nilsson and Tatiana Zdanoka, along with other members from all political groups, engaged themselves to stop the persecutions of Mr. Bivolaru. Taking into account the uniqueness of Bivolaru's case, the question about Mr. Pivolaru's situation was addressed to the European law expert Professor Lucia Rossi from the University of Bologna to give a juridical evaluation of the case.
In this case, everything happened before the accession of Romania to the European Union. So this person acquired a right of asylum. The asylum has been already given, recognized. So it is not this accession of Romania to the European Union cannot change the individual position of this subject. If Romania asks to annul this asylum, the protocol applies. It means the Council of Ministers of the European Union must be interested by the Swedish government, which I think is not convenient for Romania because it will transform an individual case in a political case. And if the Member States of the European Union find that there is a violation, a systematic violation, or freedom of religion, or freedom of association, or freedom of opinion, they could apply the procedure of Article 7, which is sanction against Romania.
Gregorian Pivolaru was acquitted in 2010 by the Sibiu Court, in 2011 by the Alba Iulia Court of Appeal, and in 2012 the Romanian Supreme Court overruled the quashing of the two previous decisions of acquittal of the defendant and maintained the case for retrial in order to offer the defendants the possibility of defending themselves, thus observing their trial rights. Human rights organizations like Human Rights Without Frontiers and Soteria International, who witnessed the Romanian Supreme Court sessions in the trial, confirm that there is no material evidence against Mr. Pivolaru in the case in point. Witnesses were harassed, pressured, and forced to make false declarations. Ignoring their own decision, the judges from the Romanian Supreme Court did not allow Mr. Pivolaru to provide testimony under Swedish protection, motivating this by stating that the Swedish authorities proved superficiality and lack of seriousness in organizing the rogatory commission. The director of Human Rights Without Frontiers, Mr. Willy Fortre, explained his point of view in OSCE event 2013.
So in May of this year, I carried out a fact-finding mission with one of my colleagues in Bucharest, meeting national human rights institutions, also members of the board of the Mises School and yoga practitioners. And quite by chance, there was a session of the Court of Cassation, the Supreme Court in Bucharest at the time, dealing with the case of Pivolaru. When I was in Bucharest at the hearing of the Supreme Court, the lawyers of Pivolaru were asking to wait until a rogatory commission could be sent to Sweden to hear what Pivolaru had to say. But quite hurriedly and unexpectedly, they decided in Bucharest to have a judgment. And that's also understandable. For the moment, Pivolaru is under the threat of being deported back to Romania because there is an international warrant. But I think that the Swedish authorities should be wise enough to wait until the European Court has released its decision. Because as I said before, I have lots of question marks on my mind in this case. This trial didn't seem to meet the fairness standards that are expected from an EU member state.
The Pivolaru case is raised every year at the OSCE Human Dimension Implementation Meeting in Warsaw. Human rights organizations, experts, Swedish authorities and European institutions follow the developments with great concern.
We briefly mention here the case of Romanian social and political activist Gregorian Pivolaru, whose court case was intensely mediatized or mediabolized, as stated in the Human Rights Without Frontiers report.
Responding to a statement regarding the case of Mr. Divolaru, a Romanian citizen and refugee with asylum in Sweden. First, I must underline that we cannot comment on an individual case. In Sweden, as in many other countries, individual cases are handled in independent courts and independent agencies, and the government, which I represent, is explicitly not allowed to intervene. Sweden takes all its international obligations very seriously, whether as a member of human rights conventions or as a member of the European Union. In the European Union framework decision, as well as in Swedish preparatory works regarding the implementation of the decision, it is stated that human rights considerations can be taken into account by Swedish courts and agencies when deciding, for example, on surrender. Thank you.
During the side event, Asylum and Human Rights Challenged by EU Directives, kept at OSC on October the 3rd, 2013, the dissident, political scientist and founder of the Romanian Helsinki Committee, Professor Gabriel Andreescu, who has published two books about the case, tracing the ongoing persecutions back to the Romanian Securitate, stated that the Romanian democracy fails in the case of Mr. Divolaru.
We have even today the same problem, a fair prosecution for persecution for Divolaru in Romania. That fear is very serious, and we have taken care, and the Swedish state has to do something, in my opinion. Okay, he has to decide in favor of human rights protection, and also is good Sweden, we look what is happening through the European Court for Human Rights.
After years of expressing their problems to different Romanian and international forums, the yogis from Romania continue to voice their concern.
Such a sentence given, Romania is not affecting only one person, but all those who are studying with Mr. Divolaru, who were trying to defend him, were practicing yoga under his coordination. Challenging the protection of Mr. Divolaru within the European Union, challenging the asylum, is practically throwing hundreds of thousands of people onto a very dangerous path of harassment in front of the media and in front of the society. And I'm not talking here about a potential danger, it's demonstrated while we're talking.
Mr. Divolaru is not yet safe, but as his case is reaching the top level of European Union politics, we can only hope that this will generate groundbreaking transformations which will secure freedom and human rights for all, as human rights advocates are expecting.
There are indeed many questions still in this case, but what has happened, and that is very positive, is that February this year, the European Parliament took two resolutions opening up for Sweden actually not to hand Mr. Divolaru over to the continued persecutions. These resolutions of the Libe Committee were very important, first of all, because acknowledging that the European arrest warrant by some countries, especially new member states, is misused. Also, it gives the European Commission the power to intervene and make sanctions when the member states de facto do not live up to the rule of law. The question remains, will Sweden then take this opportunity, this opening, to stand for the human rights as they have said they will do? Today we know that the Swedish police is still searching for Mr. Divolaru in Sweden, in his home, where he at the same time is protected. So indeed, the question is still out there, and we are many human rights activists, and not the least the experts and politicians, who wait for a clear answer from Sweden.